know what time it is? It's time for the reign of God. So if you'll stand and join us. Well, I'm rushing my musicians here. Oh, it's good to see such a full house this morning. Special video this morning from His Love about the baby bottle boomerang. You'll notice the baby bottles in the back, and I think it will all be explained in the video. In the meantime, I have a couple other announcements. She's going to work on that. The first one is that there's a Bible study starting at my house Tuesday at 9:30, and we're going to be studying this book along with our Bible. So if you are free if you are a woman and you are free on Tuesday morning, we're going to be segregating that way. So we'd love to have you. It'll be at my house. Maybe we got it now.
My mom is amazing.
Don't you love technology? Okay. The other thing is, I know we haven't been doing birthdays for a long time, so we missed a lot of birthdays. But I know there is a special birthday today. If I can see him in the crowd. This is William's 14th birthday. Oh. And I thought maybe, ooh, I see him right back there. I thought maybe we could sing a little happy birthday since we haven't practiced for so long. Can we wing a happy birthday real quick? Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear William. Happy birthday to you.
I always miss William's birthday because we're always done with school by then, so I don't usually catch him. So this year I got him good. Okay, any chance on that video yet? Nope, okay. Pick up your baby bottle in the back. Bring it back on Father's Day, right, Ruth?
Actually, the second Sunday in July.
The second Sunday in July, we're going to bring it back. Okay. Okay, we're going to stand and sing My Lighthouse.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence you won't let go, in the questions your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore. What tomorrow brings, with each morning I'll rise and sing. My God's love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore.
you. You may be seated. We're going to do a responsive reading. It's number 664 in your book, if you want to look it up.
They don't have books.
Oh, sorry, no books. Never mind. It's all up on the screen. We'll get this yet. Watch. Wait. The day of the Lord is at hand.
Like the bud on a tree, God's possibilities are about to blossom.
Stay awake. The reign of God is very near.
We are here, watching and waiting with hope.
May God bring justice to all people on this day. May God's reign come on earth as it is in heaven.
Amen. Amen. Okay, strength will rise. I'm going to have you rise with strength will rise again. We'll get your up and down today.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord our God. You reign forever. Our home, our strong deliverer. You are the as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord our God. You reign forever, our home, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. Do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You do not think you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
Amen. And you may be seated again. We're going to try something here. We're going to try doing prayer requests without microphones. So if you do have a prayer request, if you could stand and say it briefly and loudly, and then I will repeat it back to you in the mic so everybody can hear it. So is there anybody with a prayer request this morning? Yes.
Prayers again for my brother Ken.
Okay. Ken, Bob's brother in Alpena. Anybody else?
Can I do a prayer update on my dad?
Yes.
A lot of people have asked me or talked to me about how they saw a news thing on 9 and 10, which I still haven't seen myself. Mm-hmm. But they talked about how they're going to go look for my dad again. We met with the Michigan State Police back in February. before the virus started, and they brought my mom and me and my siblings into their place down in Lansing, and they gave us a tour and a lowdown, and they did a PowerPoint. They're going to use my dad's story for training for state police and the FBI across the nation. And so they gave us the whole PowerPoint and showed us all the statistics again of how they looked for him, where they think or where they know where he went down, pretty much how the whole story went top to bottom. Then they asked and told us that they've gone from like just a few part-time state police divers to 11 full-time state police divers. So they have time to go look for my dad again this year. So they said that they believe, and my mom actually said this to us kids before we met the state police, that she believes him to be under the plane. The plane is nose down in muck down at the bottom, and my mom believes that he possibly got caught right underneath the nose. So they think he is under the nose of the plane because they can't find him anywhere. And I mean, they've looked several times over all around it. I think their plan is to go look again. And if they still don't come up with anything, he's going to approach his supervisor about pulling the plane up and seeing if my dad's under there. This guy really took it to heart. The sergeant really took it to heart that he didn't find my dad. And he didn't like that. For our sake, he said he's been struggling with it since it happened. So he is really pushing to be able to get the plane up. He's got to look into who can do it and how they're going to do it, because it's so deep. But the plan is to probably take the plane out this summer. So the problem with that is that if they take it out, either the muck will fly out and they'll see him, or the muck will go on top of him. And then at that point, there is no way of getting him. So they want a camera under, so when they pull the plane up, they can at least see if he's there or not. But if the muck goes on top, that's it. He's there. He stays there. So if you could pray for us as we go back to this again. It's a lot of anxiety. My mom, like we've been saying, like we know where my dad is. We know that he's in the ground or he's in the water, but that's not where he is, and we have peace in that. But there is something to be said about going to a graveside and celebrating his life a year later, which we did a year later, but we didn't get to go see him anywhere or be with him or sit down and have a picnic at his gravestone. So that was hard, and we didn't realize how hard that would be until the year came. So it'd be nice to have a place. And my mom said, she goes, Dad always wanted to be cremated. She goes, but I'm not doing it. And so she's ready to put him in the ground and have that for herself. So if you could pray for my family, as you guys have been doing for a long time, appreciate it a lot.
Amen. So, any other prayer requests? Okay, let's go to prayer with these needs. Oh, Lord Jesus, we come to you now. Our world is seemingly in turmoil. And yet, we know ultimately that you have a plan and you have a purpose, and that you will use all of these difficulties in our lives for your good and your glory. And we just thank you for that promise. Pray now for Bob's brother, Ken, that he would just be recognizing your presence around him in his life, that he would be drawn to you, Lord Jesus. And we pray too for Bob, that he would just have words to encourage and to lift him up as well. We think about Arissa's family and the struggle that this has been since her father's airplane accident. And we just ask that you bring peace and some kind of closure there for them as well. And we ask too for protection for these people as they endeavor to move this plane. Thank you now for your goodness to us, that you walk through us with us. We know there are other needs that weren't spoken today, but we just pray that you would just hear those prayers as well, Lord Jesus. Thank you now, in your name we pray. Amen. That wasn't my plan either. I was going to sing one more song before we played, but we're going to sing that song now. The song is They That Wait Upon the Lord. stand if you'd like.
They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord, teach me, Lord, to wait. Teach me, Lord, to wait. Down on my knees, till in your own good time, you'll answer my pleas. Teach me not to rely on what others do, but to wait in prayer for an answer from you. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord, teach me, Lord, to wait.
Thank you. You can be seated. Now we have a graduate. We actually have two graduates this year. Nathaniel and Mackenzie, and I'm going to have Jubal come up now and offer a prayer for Nathaniel, and then after that, Kyle will be coming to speak to us, so I get to get away from this microphone.
Nathaniel. I don't see Mackenzie, so. Before I pray, I'm going to put Nathaniel on the spot and have him talk to you guys about what he's planning on doing.
This was a little bit of a surprise, so buckle up, here we go. This fall, I'm planning to go to Michigan Tech and study mechanical engineering. So, yeah, that's all I have.
Good choice. Need to really buckle up when you start doing that. All right, well, let's just take a moment of prayer, both for Mackenzie and Nathaniel, as well as all the other seniors in the area and around graduating. You know, this has been kind of an odd year for them, so just pray for peace as they move forward and wisdom in what they do. So let's pray. God, we just thank you so much just for the young men and women who are moving to a new part in their lives as they graduate. We just thank you for the opportunity of schooling and the learning and knowledge that they can gain from that. And now as they move into a time of college or career or wherever you lead them, God, we just pray that you would give them wisdom and understanding, God, that as they go through so many new things that they've never experienced, that they would be able to rest and rely on you. We just thank you for these families that you've blessed us with that can surround and help them as they go through whatever it is that they're moving through, God. We just thank you so much for the blessings you've given us, God. But help us to just be willing to pass those on, share those, especially with these young men and women as they transition into these new things, God. We just pray that Nathaniel and Mackenzie would just be lights as they go into the world around them, that they would just shine you to the people that they interact with and see. And we just thank you so much for blessing our community with them up to this point. And we pray that they would do great and wonderful things for your kingdom as they go. And we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning. There's actually a lot of people here. It's good to see everybody after being apart for so long. I was obviously asked to speak again, and unlike we had done previously, they're not apparently giving us any topics, so we just get to pick our own topic. I picked several for this morning. I'm just kidding. I just picked one. Actually, Tyler told me before he gave me this, he says, we only charge it up to 2 bars, so it should only last about 20 minutes. And I'm just kidding. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. I don't know if he's going to turn it off or what. So typically, when I'm asked to speak and I'm not given a topic, I typically just start with prayer and start praying and asking, you know, what the Lord would like me to speak on. And typically, what I end up coming to is something that's happening in my own life, something that I'm learning or something that I've experienced recently. And so with everything that's currently going on, it's been an interesting context to be preparing a sermon during this time. There's obviously been a lot of thoughts going through my mind, and I'm sure a lot of you have spent a good deal of time contemplating everything that's currently happening in our country, in our state, and in the world. There's been so much controversy lately. There's so much division. There's sickness. There's politics. There's riots. If you watch internationally, there's some concerning things happening that are across the entire world. And for that reason, my heart has often been heavy lately. And it's challenging to see the things that are happening, not just the things themselves, but also the way that people are choosing to react to them. I'm sure that some of you probably already know this, but this last month we lost one of the clearest voices that was bringing the light of Christ to people's minds across the world. For those of you that didn't know Ravi Zacharias, he was considered one of the greatest apologists that Christianity has ever had, and he passed away May 19th. I really enjoyed listening to his sermons and his lectures. I'd really encourage anybody to look him up on YouTube or somewhere that you get podcasts. He has a lot of really interesting messages. And I definitely know that I've been thinking in recent days, you know, typically whenever something happens of significance in the world, Ravi Zacharias was always good about issuing a statement, and it was always so well placed. He was such a compassionate and loving person, and yet in his love for people, he knew that he needed to tell people the truth. And within that context, I'm going to start on an idea that Ravi Zacharias often covered in his lectures and his sermons. He spent a lot of time debating non-Christians, opponents, skeptics of the Christian faith, and answering questions for them. And there's a very common argument that you see, and I'm sure some of you have run into it yourself, and it goes kind of like this. If God is so good, and he's so loving, and he's all-powerful, and he's in control, then how do we explain all of this evil that is in the world? And that's a hard question to answer. That is something that Christians have to grapple with. But for a skeptic or an atheist or someone that doesn't believe in God to ask this question, there's actually an error in their reasoning that Ravi Zacharias really liked to point out and use to his advantage in the argument. If you make an argument that there is evil in the world or bad things in the world, you also must be assuming that there is also good in the world. And if there is such a thing as good in the world and evil in the world,